A good place to start, Rob, if we may, is an update on the squad, on the injury front, and how the players are this week.
Okay, we had a lot of international players, 17, 18 back today in training. Most of them really good, some with some little knocks out of the games what they played. Still the same players out of available for the weekend, like Coleman, of course, he's doing well. Funes Mori, Barkley, Lennon is not fit. Of course, Bolasie is a long-term injury. McCarthy is doing full of training, but it's too short to bring him. He will do some more training sessions. He will get game time next Tuesday in the under-23s, and then I think he's really back for the first team.
Roy Keane was the latest, wasn't he, to have his say on James McCarthy, and I know he went away with the Ireland squad. How is his fitness, and did you have conversations with the Ireland squad before he went away about how he might or may not be involved?
Well, first of all, I don't know what Keane said about the situation. I'm not interested in his comments. The player had a long time, several problems physically, and we tried to solve that problem. And he's now back. The first time they did a good thing, not to use the player in the states of fitness, what the player is. And okay, and we like to bring him back. It's a good boy. It's an important player for us. And but we don't take risk. And that's good for him, that's good for us, and let's hope that he will be totally fit and available for next weekend.
How about the other players that have returned? I'm thinking perhaps the likes of Gylfi Sigurdsson, who had very good international breaks. Do they bring back with them a sense of confidence which has been lacking?
Well, sometimes it's a fresh up for players. Maybe not for everybody, but it's all depending the first team. But sometimes an international break is for everybody good. And of course, players like Gylfi qualifying for the World Champions, that gives always a good boost to the player. And that's important that they come back with a lot of positives. But we have also players with some negatives, not qualifying for the World Champions. And that's a different situation.
On that note then, I'll ask you if I can about Holland. What is your take on the state of Dutch football?
Oh, we lost quality. We lost quality in the competition in Holland. We lost quality. We don't have really the top European top players anymore. Robben was maybe the last, and he's stopping now for the national team. But yes, we have some really good talent players, but the whole competition in Holland. Young players, they go too fast abroad, and we need to change. We had a great time with a lot of big, good players, and we dropped quality. We dropped quality, and countries like Belgium and of course Germany, they changed it around it, and we need to react. But we will come back because we bring always good football players.
Perhaps unsurprisingly, your name has been linked with the job. Is it a job you fancy?
No, but I'm not surprised that they named they put my name in, because they did the same some years ago, and I'm not surprised. But I'm Everton manager, and that's the most important, and nothing else.
One day, perhaps, though, in the future, is it something?
No, but the future is not realistic now, because we have other business to do with Everton, and we need to win, and we need to change our situation on the table, and that starts this Sunday, and that's the priority for me for the long term.
How was the international break for you? You had some players here around, and obviously, as you say, 17 or 18 came back today. Was it a good thing for you to have a break from the rigors of the Premier League and Europe?
No, first of all, you like to have everybody available, but I think one reason is why we struggle is that we don't have really training sessions. And that starts already in the preseason. We did not have a normal preseason. We had to play really fast, really competition to qualify for Europe. And the schedule is so tough that you don't have really time to train and to improve. And we don't have one new player. We have 8 or 9 new players, and that takes time. That takes time, and for that I'm happy that we play on Sunday. That at least today we had a normal training session, and with a lot of attention and focus for the game of Sunday.
Is there extra pressure on Sunday's match, the trip to Brighton, given the disappointing start to the season?
Not for me. I think the pressure is always there in football, because you like to win and you put yourself under the pressure to win the game. And everything what is mentioned by press or what is outside of my hands, what I can't stop and I can't do about that.
And the games are relentless, aren't they? I saw Gylfi Sigurdsson had described the next three as being potentially pivotal to your season, with Lyon in the Europa League, Arsenal, Chelsea. They come thick and fast, don't they? How challenging is that run going to be?
Yeah, but it's not about what is coming after Sunday. The most important and the focus is on Sunday, and after that we know we need to play Lyon at home. But and every Premier League game is a tough one. It's not the name of the opponent.
Ronald, how concerned are you by the defence? Because my math suggests you've leaked 18 goals in Premier League and Europa League. How big a concern?
Not more than it was, because I know the games that we played, then you can concede it, that number of goals. And I think it's more a question to answer this question halfway the season, because we played against 4 title contenders, and then you can concede it goals.
How do you lift the mood? Because I imagine the mood can't be that good after the start and the home defeat by Burnley. Have you got a difficult management job at the moment?
No, of course it's difficult, because everybody expects different results, a different position on the table. And we did not have time, and I did not see my players from Burnley after the game till some came in Wednesday, but others came in today. And that's all about in a short period to get everybody on one line and focus for the game of Sunday. And of course, in terms of confidence, we find it difficult. In the Burnley game, we start really well. And one shot on target, it's 1-0 down, and it's a different feeling in the stadium and by the players, and that makes it even more difficult. But we know that, and we can turn around it, because the players are working so hard. They deserved different results.
Do you just have the confidence that even if it's a goal that goes in off somebody's backside, that you just need something to kickstart?
Yeah, of course. You need a little bit luck. You need to score the goal out the first chances that will create. If you play against 10 in the Cyprus team, you get a corner kick or you get a free kick against. It's not the numbers of players they can score out of that. And that is what we need to change. And the fastest way to change that situation is do your job every day and be a professional and work hard and a feeling of belief together.
Can I just finally ask what you expect from Brighton, newly promoted? I'm sure they'll be up for this game.
They are really tough. I think they are doing really well. We analyse them. They have 2 wins out of the last 2 home games against Newcastle and against West Brom. And it's a tough place to come, and what I mentioned before, it's not about the name of the opponent, because everybody is strong and can play good football.
Ronald, after the Burnley game, Farhad Moshiri came out and said that the Burnley defeat was the only unexpected loss so far this season. Given what you said about how tough the schedule has been, would you agree with that?
First of all, Burnley won away against Chelsea. Burnley had a draw away against Tottenham. and Burnley had a draw against Liverpool away. That's, I think, more clear than every answer.